I give you this ring.
As a token of my love.
As a token of my love.
And as a symbol of our marriage.
And as a symbol of our marriage. We promised each other a lot today. We can't promise that we won't fight. Can't promise that, or I can't promise that I won't make you cry. But I can promise you this: I will always love you, even when it hurts.
I hear the sound echoes beneath angels and skylines meet, and I'm straining to reach the light on the surface. Light on. Pages turning, I see the candle burning down before my eyes, before my wild eyes. I feel you holding me tighter, I cannot see. When will we finally breathe? Just turning, I see the candle burning down before my eyes, before my wild eyes. And I feel you holding me tighter, I cannot see. When will we finally
once, causes you to think twice, and if he admits to being human and making mistakes, hold on to him and give him the most you can. He isn't going to quote poetry. He's not thinking about you every moment. But he will give you a part of him that he knows you could bring. Don't hurt him, don't change him, and don't expect more than he can give. Don't analyze. Smile when he makes you happy, yell when he makes you mad, and miss him when he's not there. Love hard when there is love to be had, because perfect guys don't exist, but there's always one guy that is perfect for you.
So, Wayne, do you reaffirm your commitment to Samantha? Do you promise to love, comfort and support her for the rest of your lives together?
I do.
Do you reaffirm your commitment to Wayne?
I do.
I promise to laugh with you.
Cry with you.
Cry with you.
And grow old with you.
And grow old with you.
I will love you through whatever life may bring.
I will love you through whatever life will bring.
These promises I make to you.
These promises I make to you for the rest of my life.
Wayne and Samantha, you have renewed promises to one another today and exchanged wedding rings as a symbol of your union and commitment to each other. It is my pleasure and very great privilege to announce you to all of your family and friends as husband and wife.
When I first heard about Wayne, Samantha seeing Wayne, she telephoned me, and you know when nobody's got enough for your own daughter. And then she started explaining he's into his bikes and he likes racing. I thought, oh, okay, he might be okay, you know. So then I eventually met him when I visited Dubai, and he was okay. We met him in Mam's 80th birthday over in Dubai, and I thought, yeah, he's okay. And then the following day, he tried to kill me. Am I right? Perhaps I better explain. He offered me a go on his 450 KTM on a supercross track over in Dubai. So anyway, I survived that, and then he visited Wales, and we went out for food, and he threw his food all over me. So going from thinking I'm going to like this guy, I was still undecided. But since then, I've got to know him a lot more, and he is a genuine nice guy, and I'm so pleased that we met each other and they're both very happy.
I'm not really one for public speaking. I have a couple of coping mechanisms. One of them, I'm my right hand. The other one is picturing all of you naked right now. Miles, how many of those pills did you take?
As Gary was saying, we have people from all over the world. Patsy and Alan, all the way from South Africa. Dubai. Javi, that's it. Javi and Aline, yeah. People from all over the world. It's truly amazing how far people are willing to travel for a free meal and some drinks.
Sam. What can you say about Samantha? Anybody that knows her, it could be a long list of things to say about her. She's the youngest of our lot. And when she was young, really young, she was so quiet and just used to follow her sister around and copy her and do everything her sister did. And Victoria, thank you. Victoria used to practice her mommy skills on the both of them, but as you all know, she's grown up and she's developed her own personality, and she's become such a strong, funny, gorgeous. I don't know where she gets her looks from, but
I'd like to say a few words before I spend the next 60 years listening. Firstly, I'd like to say how gorgeous my beautiful wife looks tonight. I'd like to thank Maria and Gary for welcoming me into their family. I'm sorry you got the short end of this deal.
Before I get into my speech and start talking about Wayne and what an amazing guy he is, I think Samantha, Maria, all the bridesmaids and everyone that made this wedding possible deserve another round of applause. So thanks everyone.
For the stag, we actually went go-karting at Skids. I don't know if any of you have been there before. And I'm sitting there thinking, I've known Gary now for 27 years. And in 27 years of knowing him, he's beaten me at every single sport we've ever entered. And here I am going to Skids go-karting with motocross championships, a rally driver, and a load of other blokes I've got absolutely no chance of winning at. So we start on the first course, and of course everybody qualifies and they get on the front of the grid. I think I was about 7th or 8th on the grid. And before you know it, the first round starts. And Mike beautifully crashes into Gary on the very, very first circuit, wipes him out, and not only did I beat him, everybody beat him. That has just made the last 27 years of my life, I can promise you. So Mike, thanks mate, because that was great.
Well, I'm actually so chuffed. On Saturday, I had the best night of my life, celebrating this absolutely beautiful woman that is my best friend, and I'm so proud to call her my best friend. And what all of you girls saw 10 years ago, she looked like Lady Gaga in Oakwood. Still can't stomach a roller coaster ride, even though her hair's grown a lot glossier, a lot longer, less high. But I just want to say I'm so absolutely over the moon, chuffed to call her my best friend, and absolutely like to have the moment to help her choose a dress and see how stunning she is today, which I'm sure you all agree. And I just want to say thank you to Wayne as well for absolutely making her rock that smile that she didn't pay anything for because she had that Dr. Michael discount.
You guys raised a beautiful, strong-minded daughter with a good head on her shoulders. Maria and Gary, tonight you've given me the greatest gift of all, the gift of your beautiful daughter Samantha. And I'll thoroughly enjoy unwrapping that gift tonight.
But the Sammy that turned up wasn't quite the Sammy that I remembered, the shy, quiet, unassuming little girl. So when she got here, we gave her a car. Thought we gave her a car to drive around in. And in Dubai, the cars are actually registered to a particular telephone number. So anything at all that happens with that car, you get a text from the police to tell you something's happened in that car. Of course, Sammy's driving this car. And bearing in mind, Sammy is most definitely Gary's daughter. And we already talked about this need for speed. My phone was going bing, 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 yeah? I'm sure the police actually had me on speed dial at one time because I was getting that many texts coming through from her.
Wayne is one of those friends that's always there for you no matter what. With a drop of a hat or a phone call, he'll be there. I want to thank you so much, brother, for everything you've done for me. And I only hope that I can return the favour. So thanks, brother.
I'd like to thank Gary for his generous contribution to the wedding. Without my new father-in-law, this wedding wouldn't have been possible. Thank you very much. Just a toast for Gary.
Yeah. Now, Sammy started to go into the gym quite a lot, and she was getting into the fitness, and it was fantastic. But then we started to get a little bit worried because she was going to one particular gym always, every night, and she'd actually a little bit made up. I'm thinking, why is she going so long to the gym? She was working there so hard, and we get a bit concerned because you can get into a gym bunny, you can get a bit too extreme. And then we finally met Wayne, and he's a gym instructor. Click, click, click. Ah, now we know why she's been going to the gym so much. It was, in fact, because she wanted to get fit, but she fancied the gym instructor.
Yeah. Where am I now? Oh, yeah, the other thing you got to know about Wayne is that he's an all or nothing kind of guy, with a go home, a go big or go home kind of approach. When I first met Wayne, he just moved to Dubai and he was working in a place called Ski Dubai. For those of you who are not familiar with the place, It's similar to the Welsh dry ski slope here in Snowdonia. Is that right? You got a dry ski slope? Yeah. We'll put that on a double dose of steroids, and you've got the world's largest indoor ski slope. As I mentioned earlier, Wayne is an all or nothing kind of guy. And at the time, he lived and breathed everything about snowboarding. He used to go on snowboard holidays with his brother Guy and get up to all sorts of trouble. When he was into something, he shops like a woman. He buys like a woman buying shoes. Samantha can back me up here. He buys all the latest equipment and he makes sure he has five of everything.
Okay, and Wayne, you came into our life at this point, and you came to our house, and you took something beautiful and precious from me. You really did, yeah? I was a bit concerned about the fit, and I thought it might be a bit too large for you. So if I could have that suit back that you borrowed from me, that'd be greatly appreciated.
To my new mother-in-law, Maria. Without you, the flowers wouldn't have looked as beautiful as they do today. And Marion, thank you very much. The chocolates wouldn't have tasted as good as they do. I'd really like to thank you for all the work you've done. The wedding looks amazing. I love you. Thank you very much.
CrossFit was now the latest thing, which became a massive part of his life. He went on to open two CrossFit boxes in Dubai, which became the most busiest CrossFit boxes. And like anything, he did it the best he could. We then got into motocross, and at the start I had a little advantage over him, as I'd been riding as a kid. But you know, knowing Wayne only a few months later, he was kicking my ass in no time. And I was really struggling to keep up with him. A few weeks had passed, and I'd noticed that there'd be no more changes on the photos. And he hadn't posted anything for a while. So I thought to myself, what kind of crazy thing is Wayne getting into next? And what's he gonna drag me along with? Then a photo popped up, and it wasn't anything like motocross, skydiving, or anything crazy like that. It was a photo, a selfie of Samantha and Wayne looking the happiest I'd ever seen him. I thought, thank God, he's not dragging me into another crazy sport.
Joking aside, what we saw when Sam came back out after we'd not seen him for a long time, and I echo Gary's views here, we saw a strong, confident, beautiful young lady who came out to a foreign country. She made a life for herself out there, she got a fantastic job, she's incredibly well respected at Dr. Michael's. In fact, I understand they're even flying you back out again till December for that. And we became so proud of this girl, and not only did she do that, she actually found the man of her dreams. So we're really, really pleased you came to live with us in Dubai, and we're over the moon you managed to find Wayne there as well.
To my mom and dad, Alan and Patsy. You've always supported me, stood by my side through all the naughty times. I don't know how you manage that. And you guys flew all the way from South Africa to be with me and Samantha on our special day. Thank you very much. Love you guys.
Wayne, you are indeed a very lucky man, but you also seem to be quite a decent bloke. A bit of a lightweight as far as the booze is concerned. And you are a bock, so come the World Cup, it is going to be an interesting time. Although having lived in Wales for a few years against the Welsh, it's not been an easy time for me either, mate. So I'm sure you'll have to live with that. But we're so pleased that Champ Sammy has chosen you. And ladies and gentlemen, if you can raise your glasses and wish Sammy and Wayne health and happiness and a long and happy life. All the very best, guys.
I can't believe that these grown-ups are going to get married. The bridesmaids and
maid of honor.
You guys looked amazing today. You kept Samantha nice and calm. I'd like to thank all of you. And clean, yeah. And to the groomsmen, thanks for standing by my side. And then we've got Dan. Dan's been one of my best friends for the last 12 years, and I think he's already broken about 20 hearts in you.
Yeah? Yeah, never know.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, true. So, what I'm trying to get at here And my point of the story is that when Waynes wants something so bad, he'll give it 100% effort and dedicate everything to it. And it's clear to me, and I'm sure to everyone else in this room, that Samantha, you are that person right now, and that focus and passion that Wayne will always have for a long, long time.
Please raise your glasses to my new wife. Cheers.
Marriage isn't about finding a person you can live with. It's about finding a person you can't live without. And my friend has found that person. So here's to a lifetime of happiness for Samantha and Wayne.
But honestly, I just want to say thank you so much, because I know she keeps the circle very small, and you should all, and I do, feel very, very privileged to be here. And I just want to say I'm so chuffed to call her my best friend, because she really is, like, and I've never met anyone so loyal, and Wayne, you're so lucky to have someone like my best friend in your life. And can I just say, you get your looks from your mother.
On the minds of men everywhere who are attempting to make a determination of which road they should take.
I've been so good, I've been helpful and friendly. I've been so good, why am I feeling empty? I've been so good, I've been so good this year. I've been so good, but it's still getting harder. I've been so good, where the hell is the karma? I've been so good, I've been so good this year. Days and nights are filled with disappointments. Fine. Oh no, everything's fine. I'm not sure why I booked today's appointment. I've been so good, I've been helpful and friendly. I've been so good, why am I feeling empty? I've been so good, I've been so good this year.
The moon? Just say the word and I'll throw a lasso around it and pull it down. Hey, that's a pretty good idea. I'll give you the moon.
I believe what I say. Why does everyone have me wrong? If I told you different, would it sound the same? Would it make a difference in any way? Oh no. I know I done wrong, I'll pay for it. It's your turn to talk, for once I'm listening. Say that you don't want me, say that you don't need me. Tell me I'm the fool. Tell me you've been tortured. Tell me you've been betrayed. What I've done to you. Even if it doesn't matter, matter what's true. Say that you don't want me. Say that you don't need me. Tell me I'm the fool. Look at all this heartache. What is left? Forgetting how it started, this is how it ends. Oh no, I know I've done some wrong, I'll pay for it. But it's your turn to talk, for once I'm listening. Say that you don't want me, say that you don't need me. Tell me I'm the fool. Tell me you've been touching, tell me you've been returning what I've done to you. Even if it doesn't matter, matter what's true.